In this whiteboard movie, we will explain the concepts of regrowth, time interval, and total duration of electrolysis hair removal. To understand the process of regrowth and the ideal time interval between clearing sessions of electrolysis hair removal, we first have to understand the basics of hair growth. If we take a look at the random 10 hairs in the face, about 4 out of 10 hairs are in the resting phase, called telogen. 6 out of 10 hairs are in the growing phase, called anagen. Three days prior to the electrolysis session, the hair is shaved. During the 3 days between shaving and your electrolysis session, only the hairs in the growing stage will grow, hence the name growing phase. Notice that the first hair, early in the growing phase, still has not reached the surface of the skin. This means 5 on 10 hairs are not visible at the time of the first clearing electrolysis session. So they are not treated, as the electrologist can only treat the hair that is visible. This is called false regrowth. Let's say in a 6th hair, the shot of the electrologist failed to kill the hair. This is called true regrowth. This means you will have a total regrowth of 6 out of 10 hairs after the first session. Only one of them, in this example, is true regrowth. Now let's tackle the much asked question, how much time should I keep between the electrolysis sessions? To answer this question, you have to understand the hair cycle a little bit. Let's say hair number 4 is in her final day of resting, the day of treatment. This hair will start growing the day after the electrolysis session. It will appear on the surface of the skin within the week. The early anagen hair will even reach the surface in less than a week. This hair will keep growing for 16 weeks on the lip and 52 weeks on the rest of the face. So, 16 weeks after treatment, the first untreated lip hair starts to disappear again. Now, let's have a look what happens with the hair on the other extreme. Hair 1 started resting the day of the shaving. The duration of the resting phase is also not the same at different areas of the face. If hair 1 is a lip hair, she will be in rest for 6 weeks, before appearing on the lip. So, every lip hair appearing before 6 weeks was not visible, so not treated, during the first clearing session. On the rest of the face, the average resting duration is 10 weeks. So all non-treated hairs will be visible again after 10 weeks. Every hair appearing before 10 weeks was not treated during the first clearing. What happens with the electrolysis shot that missed to kill the hair follicle? The hair root will be quite damaged, causing the hair to be catapulted into the first day of resting before gaining the strength to regrow. So the missed shots on the lip will become visible on average 6 weeks after treatment. This means that you will have a little peak of regrowth of hairs on the lip on average 6 weeks after treatment. The missed shots of the rest of the beard will become visible after 10 weeks. Now we have explained the dynamics of hair regrowth, we can come back to the question of time interval between treatments. A frequently asked question by electrologists and clients alike is what is the ideal time between electrolysis hair removal treatment sessions? After clearing an area with electrolysis, you have to give the skin the time to heal. It takes the skin about 4 weeks to sufficiently recover from an electrolysis session. So the minimum time we advise between treatment is 4 weeks. This time interval is dictated by the skin, not the hair cycle. So the fastest electrolysis track you can take is with a 4 week interval. But as we just explained, part of the untreated hairs will not have appeared yet. This means you will need more but shorter sessions with less hairs treated per session. Of course, with travel costs, etc., this is the fastest but not the cheapest solution. The most cost-efficient track would be waiting 10 weeks between treatments. All hairs that were invisible during the first session can be treated in the second session at 10 weeks. You will need fewer sessions, but of longer duration. With 2.5 months between every session, total time frame from start to finish will be at least 1 year. To keep the middle between total time to the finish and the costs, we mostly advise a time interval of 6 weeks. So the second session takes place at 6 weeks. The untreated hairs that are still invisible during the second session can be treated in the third session after 12 weeks. All hairs are treated at least one time after the third session at 12 weeks. Because after 16 weeks the untreated lip hair becomes invisible again, the maximum time interval we would recommend is 16 weeks between sessions.